Welcome back to Living 808. Our next guest is a writer, designer, entrepreneur, and founder of LifeEdited.com. He has given 2 TED conference talks and will be speaking tonight at Ward Village as part of their Smarter Living event series. We welcome in Graham Hill. Hello, thank you so much for joining us.
Yeah, thanks for coming. Thanks for having me.
Okay, TED Talks resonated, you know, your presentation resonated with millions of people. Tell everybody what it was about and why you think it hit home for so many of us.
So I think it resonated because intuitively all of us are desiring simpler, smaller lives. And effectively, we've supersized ourselves over the last 50 or 60 years. We have huge homes, we have bigger cars, portion sizes, everything's sort of gone up. In fact, we have 3 times the space per person that we did 50 or 60 years ago. So lots more space, and yet we have a $22 billion personal storage industry. So lots of space, lots of stuff. Environmental footprints, of course, went up like crazy with that. Lots more debt, but happiness levels have basically flatlined. And so it's just, I don't believe it's working for us. And I think intuitively people sense that. They're looking for something. And so we believe that if you apply smart sort of design and are really conscious about what you bring into your life, that it's not a sacrificial thing, but you can go for quality over quantity. So I've sold a couple companies. I could live in a very large home. I, in fact, had a 3,500 square foot home at one point. I'm now living in 350 square feet in Manhattan.
Wow.
But it's really well designed, and I have just the stuff that I need and all great stuff, and I love it. And I've got a much smaller environmental footprint. I save money, and my life is really clean and organized, and it gives me time.
Yeah.
And that's what's really important to me.
I have to ask you, do you think this is an age thing? Because as I've gotten older, I'm getting what you're saying. You know, I want to simplify my life. I want to enjoy the present. You know, I'm needing less.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think it's an age?
Maybe all ages at this point, because I think a lot of the millennials, etc., are also like people. They're not buying cars, and they're realizing that it's about experiences, not mm-hmm. stuff. That's what happiness is about. And so I feel like it's happening for a lot of us.
Yeah. Now you live part time on Maui, part time mm-hmm. in New York.
Mm-hmm.
That's exciting.
Yeah.
What do you think about the trend of urban living coming to Honolulu?
I think it's fantastic. I mean, I'm a New Yorker of 20 years, and what I really love about it is that it's easy access to all sorts of amenities and people and culture and friends. Walkability is huge. Mm-hmm. And so I think that bringing that to Honolulu just makes a ton of sense. It's a wonderful thing being able to just have everything at your fingertips and not have to get in a car and organize all that. So
yeah.
I think it's great. I think also we want to go up. We want to go vertical. So we want smaller living so that we can have these incredible landscapes left instead of just suburbia covering them all over. And so I think this idea of like more density, smaller living, just done in a great way, a high quality way, a non-sacrifice way, is amazing. And it's a fantastic to see it happening right here in Honolulu.
Earlier this summer, I was in Chicago, and I love that they have these walkable neighborhoods. And I came back home, and I'm like, we don't have a lot of that here in Hawaii. But Kaka'ako area especially, you know, they're creating that. So I think that's what you're talking about.
Yes. Yes.
You also reference smarter living. For people that may not, you know, totally understand what that means, what do you mean by smarter living?
Well, our houses have ballooned to such huge sizes, and a lot of the world, like Europe, has like 1,000 square foot average. We're at like 2,700, and so it's just the idea of just applying smart design and some sort of transformation, ideally, so that you can live in much smaller places. So my 350 square foot apartment probably has the functionality of a 600 square foot apartment. And so that's sort of smaller, smarter, just editing your stuff down to the core stuff that you love, that works for you, and then just being smart about the architecture so you get the stuff that you need. Like dining rooms as an example, we call them museum rooms because They're hardly used.
Right,
so
who
why
eats in there?
Why have a room that you it costs you a lot of money to have that room? So why have it if you never use it?
Hearing you speak, it reminds me of those TV shows, which I love, those tiny living, you know, how they fit everything and they're super efficient.
Yeah.
But really, you've got everything you need there. We're almost out of time, but you are speaking tonight at Word Village.
Yes.
Can you remind everybody what time? And this is a free event.
It's tonight. I'm not sure if the tickets are for sale, but you can certainly get them at wordvillage.com.
Okay.
And I'll talk a lot longer. I've got a lot of really great stuff to share, so I'd love to see them there. And that's, I think it's at like in the 7 o'clock range, something or
okay.
like that. 6 o'clock?
It's free. So it's free and it starts at 7. Okay, so everybody's invited. And this is, I could talk to you forever because this is something I'm really passionate about as well.
Me too.
But you've got advice for people. So we really hope that people will come on down and listen to what you have to say. It's a great topic.
Thank you. We'll show a bunch of videos, a bunch of pictures too. So it'll be cool.
Good.
Please come down.
All right, Graham, thank you so much. All right, what happens when a hitman becomes the target of another assassin?